Now, there are a number of conflicts which I have seen in persons over the years. I would like to speak about a few of them so that you can have an idea what I mean by need conflicts in relationships. One conflict could be the conflict between one's need for affection or for more affection than that which is being expressed, and the other is difficulty in expressing affection. The one who needs more affection begins to doubt the other's love and starts pressuring the other in various ways to express more affection. The one who is being pressured feels danger because he's being pressured to do something which is difficult for him or her for some reason. It could be childhood programming, it could be various fears that he has for some reason. And feeling that intimidation closes off even more, which creates an even greater sense of rejection in the other. And this creates this vicious circle in which one is pressuring the other, feeling rejection, and the other who is feeling the pressure is closing off or even becoming aggressive in order to protect himself. The same can happen on the sexual level, that one, as the relationship goes on, one may have more need for sexual contact than the other. And when he doesn't receive that, he receives rejection. Rejection of himself, or rejection of his manliness, or his or her womanness. And this creates the need for the affirmation of ourselves through the sexual acceptance from the other. Pressuring the other makes the other fear, because for some reason he doesn't want to have this contact at this point. It could be a number of reasons. It could be that they're not feeling emotionally close to us, or that there are some hurt feelings, or it could be spiritual reasons or physical reasons. It doesn't matter. And this creates a vicious circle of greater rejection in the one, a feeling of pressure and fear in the other. And if they're not able to communicate about this in an effective way, it can create a great deal of misconception and separation between them. Another area of conflict, which I've seen frequently, is about cleanliness and neatness and order, in which one has a greater degree of need for cleanliness and order than the other. When the other does not help in creating that clean and orderly environment, which the first needs in order to feel secure and relaxed in that environment, begins to pressure the other. That pressure causes the other to feel suppressed and lack of freedom. He reacts often by doing even less to help out in creating an orderly or clean environment. And this creates a vicious circle between them, in which both of them feel that an injustice is being done to them. The one, that the other is not helping me create the environment which I need, and the other, that this person is pressuring me to create an environment which I don't need. And both of them feel unhappy. And how are we going to solve these problems? We need to learn to communicate about this. Other areas could be social contact, that one of them wants to have more frequent social contact and the other doesn't. How do they solve those problems? Another could be that one wants to spend the money that they have now, and the other may want to save it for the future, or put it in the bank, or put it into land or buildings. Whether they're going to watch TV, or whether they're going to listen to music, or whether they're going to read. How to bring up the children, if the children should be controlled to a great degree, or whether they should be left free to make their own decisions. Often a source of conflict between the couple, within the couple. Another area is whether we're going to talk about our problems, or whether we're going to leave them, whether they'll be solved in other ways. For example, the woman usually, it's not exclusive to the woman, but in general, the woman usually needs to talk more than the man. And this talking is just a process of connecting. The man sees talking as a way of solving problems. for example, the woman may say, well, I had this problem today, and the man will simply say, well, do this, and it's finished for him, you see. But that's not what the woman was looking for. The woman is looking for a discussion, a way of connecting, not interested enough in simply having a solution. He can't understand that, because he sees talking as simply a way of finding the solution, then the discussion is finished, you see. And so this often creates problems in which the woman feels that her need for communication, her need for connection, is not being fulfilled. The man feels pressured to do something he doesn't consider very useful or worthwhile or necessary, because he may feel that unity in another way, not so much through words. And so all of these are differences in needs and ways of thinking which exist between us. And if we're not mature, and if we don't have enough love within us, it can create a tremendous amount of tension and even separation in the relationship. So it's important to learn how to dive deep within ourselves and find what is going on within us, which is preventing us from being able to respond to the needs of the other. Do we have some bitterness in us? Is it childhood programming, which is not allowing us to respond to my loved one's needs? Or is it that I don't believe in that? That it's something which is not within my value system? And so in such a case, this has to be discussed. It is because there are value conflicts and there are need conflicts. When it's a need conflict, we can probably find a solution. When it's a value conflict, when my spouse is asking me to do something which has no value for me, such as social activity or taking trips, then I have to explain to them, you see, I love you, but I can't do that. I would come into conflict with my conscience. As much as I love you, I cannot do things in life which bring me into conflict with my inner self. Other things which do not bring us into conflict with our inner self, we can try to overcome those programmings and accommodate. And also see the programmings within us which are demanding something from the other which they cannot give us. And is my lesson in this case to learn to demand it more assertively? Is my lesson to remove the subconscious beliefs which create doubt whether I deserve what I'm asking from the other? Or is my lesson to learn to be happy without receiving what I'm asking? So each person has to search within himself in these relationship situations to see what is my lesson here, and what I need to change in myself in order to feel harmony with this person, even if he or she does not change. It's a very important question.